Namaste. Today I am going to explain how to write a script for educational videos. Before going for the educational video, you need to have some paperwork. Write everything on the paper, rehearse it, and then only do the educational videos. Now, educational videos can be anything, like you are standing alone, you are speaking, or you are sharing the presentations, or you are presenting various learning material in front of the students. So it can be any way, but there should be a script for these educational videos to understand the pedagogy of that particular video. Now, what should be the point and how it should be written? I am going to explain it in my way. I do develop educational videos and I use this method of writing a script. So I will explain you. I have opened this the Word file. So this is the actual script. This is just a sample script. But before that, I will explain the pedagogical parts of this script. So what point should be included in the script? Name of the presenter. B, topic. The main concept, the main theme that you have selected. For example, I have selected e-library for BA students. Then C, subtopics. So how many sub-concept that you are going to cover, how many points that you are going to cover in this video, in that particular video, that you need to mention. Suppose you are taking World War II, then causes and effect or whatever is there. If you are taking some chapter from a textbook, then you need to mention paragraph 1, 2, 3 or stanza 1, 2, 3 in that way. What is the approximate time duration you are expecting? As it is told by many of the educationists, it should not be more than 10 minutes. I have selected 7 minutes. I need to mention the learning outcome. Sometimes it is said the objective and specification. Sometimes it is said the learning competencies, whatever. I write it in the form of learning outcomes. Learning outcome, it carries one learning outcome to each concept. Suppose this was first topic, concept. So this learning outcomes related to first subtopic. This is second subtopic and learning outcomes of second subtopic. So in this way, each subtopic need to have some learning outcomes. Third. So in this way, write the learning outcomes for each subtopic. Then next, some technical parts, what hardware you are going to use, a camera phone and a mobile stand because you want to shoot a video. Then is there any software required for creating this e-content? Yes, so I need PowerPoint presentation, so I will prepare a PowerPoint presentation where that all the subtopics will be included. Then I will need Active Presenter software. So where I will use this Active Presenter software to present my PowerPoint presentation along with me, and that will convert a video. A plot required where I will shoot it. I am going to shoot it at my home itself. You can write it at a college or whatever plot you have decided to shoot a video. Next point is what learning material is required. So here, for example, I require PowerPoint presentations with 10 slides. I should be very precise when I am writing a script. It should be so precise that if even I hand over this script to other person, other presenters, she even be able to present this video. So PowerPoint presentation with 10 slides. Then I need two screenshots. E-library websites, 3 Indian websites and 4 international websites. So I will present those screenshots in the PowerPoint presentation. I need 2 charts, educational uses of e-library and limitations of e-library. Even that will in the e-form that I will present in the PowerPoint presentation. So I'm very precise. These are indicating the numbers because it's everything about the time. You need to be very precise when you are presenting a video. It should not be be too lengthy. That's why you need to be very precise in numbers. So how many charts you required? So when you decide all these pedagogical aspect, you prepare all the things accordingly. You need to prepare some software like PowerPoint, prepare a PowerPoint presentations, collect all the e-learning materials, and once it is collected, then reels on the camera, and then start writing a script. Do not sit and directly write a script, because you need to know the timing required for it. So you cannot simply give any timing in the air. You need to have the experience of it. So when you are doing the rehearsal, rehearse it and set the time, see the time and write the approximate time. So that rehearsal is very required when you are writing a script. And then write a script. Like there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 column in this table. This is just a format. You can add some columns if required, or you remove some column if you want to. Now first is subtopics. Like main topic is the e-library, subtopics first is intro. And my commentary when I am introduction, so it's introduction of myself and introduction of the topic. So presenter's activity, here I am what presenter will do. I will speak this matter and I will play a slideshow. What learning material? The introduction slide. And approximate time I have given 10 seconds. Then coming to the second subtopics, example of e-library. So I am going to say this first. So what is presenter activity during this, when I am making the commentary? So my activity will be I am speaking and I am clicking on the next slide. It will take approximate 3 seconds. Then next, then I am showing next learning material and I am making this commentary about various screenshots. So I am showing first them the sample of e-library, and then I am going to explain it what is e-library. So I have used the inductive method where I am showing example first and then going for the definition. So I will speak this. I will show the screenshot in my PowerPoint presentations and what material required, the screenshot of National Library of India. In the next activity, then I will show the next slide. And I am speaking about the screenshot, which is the screenshot of website of British Library London, and I will require 10 seconds. So in this way you can carry on and cover all the topics, subtopics, and mention the duration required in seconds, 10 seconds, 3 seconds, and finally make the total. It should be matched with the time that you have mentioned, 7 minutes. So it should be matched with that approximately. And if you write any instruction about it, anything that you have not covered over here, so you can write here. So in this way you can write a script. So this is basically this is the script, and these are the pedagogical aspects of the script. So in this way you can write a script for educational videos, which is having the technological aspect and the pedagogical aspect both. So if you want, you can take the screenshot of this table, take the screenshot, so it will help you to write your own script by using this column heading. Remember, these are not the final one. You can add or remove some columns as per your requirement of the topic. Even you can take the screenshot of these points, so that will help you to write your own script. And if you have some more suggestions, please give it into the comment section. Thank you.